Welcome to the first episode in the World Building series. In this video, we will investigate gods and divinities and the roles these beings can have in the world you are creating. By the end of this video, you will be able to describe how your world was created, the mythology of your world, and how the gods maintain a connection with your world. Before we begin, please take a moment to like this video and subscribe to the channel. If you like this video and would like to see more, check out the Next Level Writing website. The link is in this video's description. Now, it's God Mode time! Cultures throughout history have recognized different forms of divinities. These range from gods and heavenly beings to demons and spirits. While divinities may be different across cultures, they have common characteristics. These include immortality, power, and a strong influence over the world. Also, they are usually responsible for the creation of the world. The first thing you need to do when world building is answer the question, how was your world created? While there are infinite answers to this question, a great place to start is to consider a primordial god. This is what a primordial god is. A primordial god or gods are ancient beings who are responsible for creation. They are extremely powerful and are often shrouded in mystery. It is the actions of the primordial god that result in the creation of life and the universe. Here are some possible primordial god examples to help get the ideas flowing. Perhaps the primordial god is a mammoth cosmic being who eats stars and then excretes new worlds. Or it could be a turtle who grew a world on its back and is now flying through space. Or maybe the primordial god is a master painter who is moving through the universe, painting whatever ideas come to mind. Hopefully, these three examples highlight just how creative you can be. Once you have decided upon the primordial god and how it created the world, think of a name. It could be vague like the creator, or it could have a unique name. The choice is up to you. Now that you have decided how your world is created, you need to focus on the second question. What god or gods exist in your world? To assist you answer this question, here are three categories for you to decide from. Following each category, there will be a short evaluation of the positives and negatives of each category. The first category is monotheism. Monotheism is the belief that there is only one god. This god may be the same as the one responsible for creation, or it may be different. This category is the one that is commonly believed by Christianity, Islam, and Judaism. The positives for monotheism are that the mythology is simple because there is only one god who is responsible for everything. It is also easier to place the god in the background and not have a huge impact on the rest of the world. The negatives are that the mythology can be a bit boring because it forces minimal interaction or influence between God and the world. There's also limited chances to be creative. Now to polytheism. Polytheism is the belief in multiple gods. Think Greek or Roman gods, for example, with each god having a specific responsibility. In this category, it can be much more complex, but also much more engaging. The positives for selecting polytheism include an interesting mythology that can be filled with drama. It also can provide a foundation for future stories and adventures. On the other side, the negatives of polytheism are that the mythology can become complex and open-ended, meaning that you can spend unlimited time on it. Now to your third option, animism. Animism is the belief that spirits possess all things. This includes nature, phenomenon, animals, and even human creations. Basically, everything is alive because spirits are in everything. The positives for animism include a one-size-fits-all mythology that can coexist with monotheism and polytheism. It also shows a strong interaction between the spirits and the world. In the negatives, the mythology can become more like a documentary with minimal godlike attributes to characters. It can also become a little bit overwhelming. Now that we have looked at the three categories of gods, let's have a look at an example for each. Inspired by monotheism, here is the Light Harvester. The Light Harvester watches over all of creation and protects it from outside forces,
but it does not interact with the world itself. It is believed that the light harvester was born when the world was created. Inspired by polytheism, meet Sip, Muk, and Tribo. These three gods hatched from the same celestial egg, making them siblings. As soon as they were born, though, they instantly began fighting. As a result of the fight, Sip became ruler of the celestial world, responsible for light, life, and power. Muk was thrown down towards the world and became the ruler of the atmosphere. That meant that Muk was responsible for the harvest, love, and warmth. Unfortunately for Tribo, he lost the fight and was thrown down to the world. He was so bitter from the battle that he declared war on Muk and Sip. Tribo saw the power of death as a weapon and took responsibility for death, decay, and darkness. Now for our last example, animism. For this example, spirits are broken up into three tiers: gold, silver, and bronze. Gold spirits are those of the human characters. Silver spirits are in the rest of nature, while bronze spirits are in all things that are man-made. Spirits can be promoted or demoted through certain rituals. It is now time to answer the third question: how do the god or gods influence the world? To answer this question, we will look at three areas: physical, interaction, and worshippers. First, the physical. The physical refers to the natural or man-made impact of the gods. For natural, the impact is geographical location caused by the gods. Perhaps a river was caused by the tears of a god, or a mountain is believed to be where the god lives. It is important to note that the story behind the creation of natural landmarks does not have to be true, but could be believed to be true by the dwellings of the world. The man-made impacts are any places of worship dedicated to God by people. It could be altars, churches, statues, absolutely anything made by people to appease the gods. Now to interactions. Interactions between gods and the dwellings in your world will depend on the choice you made earlier about the category of gods for your world. But essentially, you need to think about whether the gods are heavenly evolved or have limited involvement. Let me explain. Heavily involved gods would come down and physically interact with the creatures in your world. They may even have relationships with others and create families and children. Limited involvement would mean that the gods have little interaction with the world and become more mysterious. Due to their lack of interaction, some may not even believe that the gods exist. Another way that the gods may interact with the world could be through visions or dreams. They could even have specific actions, such as possessing particular creatures. Lastly, you need to think about worshippers. Worshippers are those that admire the gods and show their admiration. They might do this through sacrifice, prayer, singing. There are absolutely infinite ways to show your worshipping of gods. Worshippers can also vary in devotion. You can have fanatics who dedicate their lives to serving a god, or you can have those who worship their god in secret, perhaps ashamed of their beliefs. This makes it possible for more conflict in your world, as some worshippers may be in conflict with others, leading to great battles being fought in the name of gods. Now that you have considered the answers to these focus questions, you have everything you need to build a mythology for your world. But before you begin, here is one last piece of advice. Spend some time looking at the mythologies that have existed throughout time. The Roman, Greek, and Egyptian mythologies can be great sources of inspiration. Also, try and unpack each one of your answers and add as much possible as detail. The more detail, the more your mythology will come to life. You may even choose to make a family tree like this one to show how the gods interact with one another. And that, authors, is that, the first episode in the World Building series. What gods have you created for your world? Let me know in the comment section below. As always, remember to like and subscribe, and keep striving to take your writing to the next level.